It just kind of sat there in my lap looking up at me, and I just kind of froze.
Talk about an unexpected find. That biologist helping to save turtles on Sanibel stumbled upon a human skull. NBC2's Michael Coliani spoke exclusively with the man who found the remains about his not-so-typical day in paradise.
I've been doing gopher tortoise excavations for over a decade, and I've come across a lot of crazy things, but this is the craziest.
David Meeson was going about his typical day as a biologist, helping to relocate gopher tortoise nests to safer locations off Wolfert Road on Sanibel Island. But while he was digging, he stumbled upon what he thought was a coconut.
You know, dug behind it to pop it out to check it, and that's when it landed in my lap, and I realized this is not a coconut.
But rather a human skull.
It literally just like a cartoon just popped and fell into my lap and was looking straight up at me.
He immediately called Sanibel Police, who responded with Lee County Sheriff's Office investigators within minutes.
You can see a Lee County Sheriff's Office crime scene unit trailer parked in the woods just about 100 yards north of the road here. Investigators tell us that they plan on remaining on scene for the next several days.
It's very surprising to me. I mean, this is a very quiet neighborhood.
Neighbors we spoke with were in disbelief.
Maximum crimes happening here is a speed ticket.
This is such a warm community place, but we don't know how long, you know, something like that's been out there.
The Sanibel police chief says he doesn't believe this to be a criminal case. Several neighbors tell us there are old burial grounds scattered across the island, but you never know.
It was just kind of a surreal thing that you're looking at a person that existed, that did things.
David says he'll head right back out to continue saving animals, but today was a day he soon won't forget.
It was pretty surreal to find a human skull when I was kind of hoping to find a gopher tortoise, so makes for an interesting day.
On Sanibel Island, Michael Coliani, NBC2.